Good morning, my dear students. We are discussing Chaskit Goes to School since last 3 days. So, in the last of the session, the last part of the session, we have seen that how, because of her physical condition, Chaskit's physical condition, she was not able to go to school. Even though she had dreamed for to go to school. So let us discuss how Abdul helped her in the mission to go to school. So as we have seen in the previous part of the lesson, she was convincing to her grandfather that please, I want to go to school. I want to experience all those things, but her grandfather walked away angrily. So, continuing the next line of the paragraph, Memele does not understand how I feel, said Chaskit. I remember the day my brother recited his staple with such pride, even the time he learned to read. My parents were very happy, as they have never been to school. I too want to learn to read and do maths. Do you understand? I do, said Abdul. Chaskit, I will see you again. I must go now. My mother will be waiting for me. Julie. So here we will see, as her grandfather walked away angrily, Chaskit said to Abdul that he is not really some person to understand my feelings. You know, I remember my brother when he recited the table with pride, when he learned to read. My parents were very happy. She is telling that my parents did not go to school. Then also they were very happy for him. So even I also do maths. I want to learn everything, she is telling to Abdul. Abdul said, yes, I do understand. Now he said that now I should go to home. My mom have been waiting for me. So telling her goodbye, he went. See the next para. The next day, Abdul went straight to the headmaster's room after assembly. Julie Azangle, he said, I want to talk to you about a girl from our village who does not go to school. Her name is Chaskit. She is Stockton's sister. So Abdul, next day Abdul went to principal's office and he wished him, Azangle. Azangle means it is a word. It is a kind of word we say to the respected person. So we say that usually Azangle. Azangle means elder person. And he directly told to principal that I want to speak about the girl in my village who cannot come to school. And her name is Chaskit. She is Stockton's sister. See the next lines. Oh yes, replied the headmaster. I know her. She has a disability, doesn't she? Yes, Azangle. She uses a wheelchair to move around but cannot reach school, as the path from her home is too rough and uneven. I was wondering if we could do anything to help her. Azangle, we could all get together and level the path and also build a small bridge across the stream. So he said that Abdul is telling to the headmaster that yes, I remember that girl. The girl has a disability. So Abdul replied that yes sir, correct, you have identified that girl. So Abdul was asking to sir, asking to principal, should we do any kind of help? So Abdul is telling to headmaster, she has a wheelchair to move around because the path is not okay, it is rough and uneven. So she shouldn't come to school. I was thinking that why can't we all get together and make the road even, if it is possible, even we can make, if it is possible, we can make a bridge across the stream. Okay, so moving towards the next paragraph. Assembly. Last week we read about the fundamental rights of citizens in our civics class. All children have a right to education. That includes Chaskit as well, does it not? Yes, you are right, Abdul. Let me discuss this with other teachers, replied the headmaster. The next day, the headmaster called all the teachers to a meeting. He shared Abdul's ideas with the group and asked the teachers what they felt. Impossible, said one of them. How can we have such a child in our school? How will she be able to write, play or and go to the toilet like the other children do? So he is telling that yes sir, last week we have studied about the fundamental rights about the citizens in civics class. Fundamental rights means some basic types of freedom we must have. The people who live in a country, they are called as a citizen. So fundamental rights are something that are equal to everyone. Fundamental rights was there in our civics class. So it is a right to educate all the children. Chaskit is a child. She is 9 years old. She has a right to study. So principal said, you are right, Abdul. Let me discuss with the other teachers. And next day, headmaster called all the teachers for the meeting to share Abdul's ideas and ask teachers what they felt. So somebody said that it is impossible, that how can she go to toilet, how can she play. The question was genuine. Now see what happened next. See the next paragraph. That's exactly what we have to work out, said the headmaster. I hear that in the village of Mentokyal, the village education committee has helped build a special toilet for a child with a disability. We could ask them what they have done. But first we will have to get Chaskit to school. Then we could think of ways of helping her do things in school. So principal told we have to work out that particular things, how to make her come to school and how to make her to cross the stream and all. So later we can think, later on we can think, because there is a village, Mentokyal, the neighbor village, that education committee, they made the toilet for the disabled child. So we can ask them that if they can do something for that. But something we should make Chaskit to make to come in the school. That is our primary responsibility. Now see next what happened. See the next para. After two weeks, there was a great excitement at the government school. All the children had gathered outside in the playground. They had come to school without their school bags. There were going to be no classes today. So here we can see after 2 weeks there was an excitement at the government school. All the teachers, students, everybody was excited. Why they were excited? And all the children were gathered on the playground, and they were asked not to bring their school bags. See the next lines. The teachers divided the children into groups. One group worked in front of Chaskit's house, and another on the path down the stream. A third group with some of the older children worked hard to help some of their teachers build a strong wooden bridge across the stream. The children laughed and sang as they removed stones and rocks, leveled the path and carried wooden planks to the stream. So here, see here children, the teachers divided children into three different groups. So one group worked in front of Chaskit's house, and the another group worked on the path on the stream, and the third group, some of the older children helped to the teachers. Why? To build a strong wooden bridge across the stream. The children, they laughed, sang, they removed the stones, they pick up the stones, they move the stones and wooden logs, moving all those things. So they sang merrily, and everyone was working so merrily. Everyone was excited because all children wanted that Chaskit should come in the school. So moving towards the next para, the headmaster went from one group to another, making sure that all went according to plan. Chaskit's parents provided everyone with hot tea and biscuits. Chaskit's grandfather sat under a willow tree by the stream, watching the busy school children. So here we can see headmaster was taking a round in each group, making sure that all the children are doing their duty accordingly or not. Chaskit grandfather, first we will discuss about the parents. So Chaskit's parents have provided tea and biscuits, snacks, because they were helping Chaskit to go to school. So Chaskit's parents were happy. So Chaskit's grandfather, he was sitting under a willow tree by a stream and watching the busy children, and he started to thinking. What he had started to thinking, let us see. See next para. I never dreamed I would see a day like this, he thought to himself as he wiped a tear that rolled down his cheek. At the end of the day, it was a tired but happy group of children that returned to their homes. The path from Chaskit's home to the school was now ready. Chaskit was going to school for the first time in her life, and that's why she was so excited. So because the grandfather, who was one who said Chaskit that stop thinking about going to school, even he said that he didn't have the capacity to go to school, be at home and learn as much as she can. So all that he remembered, he was remembering all that things, and his tears were rolling on cheek. So though it was a really tired and busy day with lot of work, but children were happy and returned back to their homes. The path of Chaskit to go to school was ready. So Chaskit was going first time to the school in her life. this is the first time that she was going to school. That is why she was so excited since morning. So this is the way children working throughout the day. So she was happy. One day, after a long awaiting of day, her dream is going to come in true. So this was the lesson. Chaskit goes to school. So she woke up early in the morning, and so she was excited. So ending the session of this lesson, I would say that hope you have understood the lesson. And you also understood the value of education, the right to education, that every child should get the education. Okay, so write the words, new words, English notebooks in your notebook with day, date and lesson name. Read the lesson very carefully. Okay, so see you next time. Bye. See you.